I think, you know, when we started the season, I think we had high hopes, but we also knew we had a lot of young guys. So there was a concern on how they would develop throughout the season. We had a great preseason. Team gelled, you know, tremendously, which that when that happens, great things can happen, I feel. I thought the young guys really came along. They got matches in early. Some guys missed. I was kind of bummed that Josh Popple missed a couple of the beginning tournaments where you could have got a lot of matches in. But everybody got their feet wet, got a lot of matches. So that was good. It was exciting. And you know, as everything we do, we get ready for NCAAs at the end of the year. So those tournaments got us ready. You know, high school is a lot different than college. It is a grind in college, and some of these guys haven't been injured in high school, and they don't know how to deal with it. They don't know that it's not going to feel 100%, but I'm okay. If I trust in the trainers and the doctors and the coaches and say I'm okay, then I can go with it, and that's a learning process, and I believe our guys did it. We were going 5-6 freshmen in a starting lineup at times, and yet they still responded. You know, they might not have gotten their hand raised, but I felt that, you know, we'd wrestle the match and come back to the practice room and get after it again. The matches that Steven wrestled, there were a lot of matches. He wrestled a lot. He wrestled in every competition. And there were times where we were concerned, is it too much? But I feel in the end run, when looking back on it, is that's what got him over the hump and to perform at the national tournament. That grind got him to be able to grind through matches at the national tournament. Will we do the same thing next year? Probably not, but I don't know that. You know, I mean, I think we can treat him differently as far as, okay, again, I've achieved that now. How do I get from 8 to top 4? You know, and that's going to be a different jump. So I thought it was good for Steven. It was hard going through it, but he handled it well, and it came through for him. Walter, he's a pinner, and anytime you have that, we always say it gets you to the next round no matter what the score is. If you can put someone on their back and pin them, you get your hand raised and move on, and that's a huge weapon. And he can do it to anybody. He was doing it at the national tournament. You turn somebody once or twice, you're going to be in charge of that match. And he has been, and everybody knows what he does on top. So it's, you know, they're trying to counter it, and they can't at times, you know, and that's exciting because if you have that weapon, you're going to be in any match. So, you know, that was good for him, you know, to be able to do that. You know, I don't think he wrestled his best at the Nationals, but dang it, he wrestled well enough to be top 8 in the country, and that is not an easy task, especially there's so many guys that lose first round, second round, and then, you know, don't end up placing because it's too tough. You know, it's too mentally tough, and he's got the character to do it. So I was impressed with him. That was good. Now we've got to get him to that point where, okay, let's get to the top 4. Let's you know, see if we can get to the finals. You know, it's going to take a little bit, but I know he can do it. When he believes, when he figures out how good he is, the sky's the limit, and he's just young, and we've been telling him all year. We watch him in the practice room and see what he can do. Especially out in Vegas when he wrestled that way, we're like, you know, you can really, you know, do what you want here. It's not, you know, he had some doubt towards the end of the year. And I think he dealt with some injuries that kind of helped kept him off the mat with his training. You know, I'm expecting big things from next year right away. He's that good. Very talented, works hard. And I think for him more than anything, because he's just, I think he's a puppy in the sport. You know, he's going to do well. I told Brian, you know, he's one of the most selfless people I've ever met. As far as everything for him was about his team, his teammates, and he came second. And you don't see that often, especially in the sport of wrestling. I think it's a selfish sport where we have to do what you need to do to get better. You know, Brian was someone who throughout the 4 years was a great leader, even as a freshman, who cared about his teammates, whether it's on the mat or off the mat, would do anything for him. That's a pleasure to coach. There's a bond there that's going to last a long time just because of the kind of person he is. You know, I hope that trait gets spread to other guys on the team. Other guys on the team look up to him, and I think hopefully they say that that's the kind of person I want to be, not just wrestler that I want to be. So that's going to be missed. Corey, you know, I obviously known him for a long time, and I mean it. I'm not sure if I will coach someone like him again as far as what he puts in to his sport and his desire to be the best that he can be is second to none. The tragedy of it is that he just never had an opportunity to do it healthy. And I would, you know, I think a lot of people, not just me, but a lot of people would like to see him do it when he was 100% healthy, because we see what he can do. We see glimpses of it. It's going to come to him. It really is. Somehow it's going to come that he's going to be ready, you know, to achieve. I don't think he's done yet. You know, I think he's got more to give because of what he puts into his training and just his pursuit of excellence is unbelievable. It's very inspiring. That's all.